Hi and welcome back to my channel. In the past few months I have been building a motorized system to move the camera when I shoot video footage. The idea behind this project is to shoot footage with a very smooth and stable movement in an easy way and without having to redo it many times. I had actually already built something similar back in June, the problem is that it just didn't work. Anyway, the whole project started from the idea of moving the camera placed on the tripod using a remote control with a joystick. After solving many problems in the mechanical part, I was able to do exactly that. Once the mechanical part was working, I worked on the electronic part and wrote the code for the Arduino. The robot has so many functions to make great video takes, such as an automatic mode to make movements that are always the same and the mode to make timelapses, like the one you are seeing now. But now, let's get started! This project is quite complex, and a lot of components were needed to make it, including screws, motors and electronics. However, in my opinion, the robot works really well, not only for moving shots, but also for still shots, because you can move the camera really precisely. This robot is meant to be mounted on a tripod, and it has horizontal and vertical movement. The robot has a mount on top on which to mount a camera or a smartphone. To move the camera, I used two stepper motors. Stepper motors can make very slow and precise movements, which is why they are used in all 3D printers. Stepper motors, however, cannot be powered directly like regular motors, but need a driver like this one. The driver is connected to an Arduino, which determines how much each motor should move. The drivers I used are the TMC2208, which compared to other drivers make the motors completely silent. To make the structure on which to mount the motors I used a 3D printer, with which I was able to make very precise PLA parts. Of course, before printing I spent several hours drawing the parts on the computer. Once the parts were printed it was time to assemble them. To make the vertical movement of the robot I printed these 5 parts and finished them in some spots with sandpaper. Then I took 2 ball bearings and put them in the hole of the 2 sides of the robot. To hold the different 3D printed parts together I cut 2 pieces of an aluminum tube. I inserted the 2 aluminum tubes into the holes in the 2 sides and the centerpiece, and attached them to the 2 sides with M3 screws. Then I took the stepper motor and screwed it to one of the 2 sides. At this point we need something to mount the camera on. So I cut a piece of 9mm MDF and drilled some holes where the camera will be attached with a 1/4-inch screw. I drilled many holes so that I could balance the camera by choosing which hole to attach it to. Then I screwed these 2 3D printed parts to the sides of the MDF piece. Into these 2 parts I put 2 M5 bolts. To carry the movement from the motor to the camera I will use 2 pulleys and a belt. The 2 pulleys are of different sizes, so as to reduce the speed and increase the force. I took the larger pulley and inserted it on one of the 2 bolts. Before inserting it, I put a piece of double-sided tape on the pulley to increase the friction between the metal and the 3D printed part. After the pulley, I put some nuts, a washer and a small 3D printed adapter, which allows me to insert the 5mm bolt into a ball bearing with a larger hole. I also put the same adapter on the other side and put the center piece between the two sides, but I had to disassemble everything again to do that. I was forgetting to put the belt in the pulley before reassembling everything. Then I put the smaller pulley on the motor axle. To tension the belt, I made grooves so that the motor could be pushed down by loosening the screws. I did a test and the vertical movement seems to work. However, getting to this point was not easy, and I had to make multiple versions of the whole part. Now we can move on the horizontal movement, which is actually very similar to the vertical movement. For this part, I printed this piece where I put two bearings, one above and one below. This part will also be used to mount the robot on a tripod. So I took this nut with a 1/4-inch thread and drilled two holes in the edges. With these holes, I attached the nut to the 3D printed part with two countersunk bolts. Then I cut a piece of threaded rod, and to thread it into the bearings with as little clearance as possible, I printed two more adapters. I attached the threaded rod to the bearings with two self-locking nuts, without tightening too much, to avoid damaging the bearings. Again, the large pulley is on the threaded rod and the small pulley is on the motor. I aligned the center part of the robot with the holes where the camera will be mounted, and attached it to the aluminum tubes with self-tapping screws. I put the whole vertical movement structure on the threaded rod, and secured it with a nut. And so, I would say the mechanical part is finished, but to see it in operation we need all the electronics. As I said before, to run the motors we need drivers, which will be connected to an Arduino Uno. The drivers will be mounted directly on the robot, and will be connected with an Ethernet cable to the Arduino that will be put in the remote control. I soldered on a piece of cardboard an RJ45 socket to connect the remote control, connectors to mount the drivers and JST connectors for the motors. On the 12V supply of each driver I put a capacitor. Then I made all the connections under the perfboard using wires with silicone sheeting, which does not melt with the heat of the soldering iron. To mount the board I 3D printed a box with a hole for the RJ45 port. I also connected a 12V power connector and a switch to the perfboard. As always, I forgot to run the wires through the hole in the box, so I had to resolder them two times. I connected the wires for the two motors to the JST connectors, and closed the box with its lid. Now we can move on to the remote control with which we can control the camera's movement. On the remote control there are some buttons, two potentiometers, a joystick and an LCD display with I2C interface. In the remote control I also put an Arduino Uno. Then with another piece of cardboard I created a shield for the Arduino with JST connectors on it to connect the various controls of the remote, which are connected to the various pins of the Arduino. Of course, I soldered wires with a JST connector to the various components that will be mounted on the remote control panel. The structure of the remote control is also 3D printed. Inside the box, I mounted the Arduino and the Ethernet jack to which the electronics that are on the robot will be connected. The remote control panel has holes in which to mount the buttons and the potentiometers. On the panel I also put the switch to choose between the three modes of operation. To mount the joystick I made a 3D printed bracket, but I don't like it at all, so I think I will make a better one soon. As a last thing I glued the LCD display. I close the remote control with screws and we are done. At this point I wrote the code for the Arduino, and after writing 500 lines of code and solving about a million problems, it all seems to work. I mounted the robot on the tripod that I normally use for the camera, and on top of the robot I put a quick release plate to mount the camera. I connected the remote control to the robot with an Ethernet cable. To power the robot I used a 12V power supply, but maybe in the future I will add the option to power it with batteries. Now that the robot is on, we just have to try it out. With the toggle switch in the middle position we are in live mode, so we can control the horizontal and vertical movement of the camera with the joystick. With the two potentiometers we can set two speeds, and we can choose which one to use with the A and B buttons. On the display we can see the two speeds, the chosen speed and the X and Y position of the motors. With the home button we can return the camera to position 0, while pressing the center joystick button and home combined set a new 0 position. By moving the toggle switch to auto we are in automatic mode. In this mode we can set two positions by pressing set and the A or B buttons, and have the camera move between the two positions automatically by pressing A or B. This mode is very useful for taking shots of objects with very smooth and precise movement. Timelapse mode is for making timelapse videos with the camera moving a little bit with every shot to get a really nice effect once the frames are put together in a video. Here again we set the start and end positions of the movement, and with the two potentiometers we set the total number of photos and the time between the photos. All we have to do at this point is to start the timelapse on both the robot and the camera. This robot will be really useful for me to make better and better videos while wasting less time on filming. If you want to build it yourself, you will find the written guide with all the information, the code for the Arduino, the files to 3D print and the wiring diagrams in the video description. I hope you enjoyed this video as much as I enjoyed making this project. If you want to see more electronics videos like this one, please subscribe to the channel, and we will see in the next video.